Thank you very much, Prasaka, and our dear listeners. What first of all, I would like to say that Uganda has a law under which we operate. And those laws are a depiction of the plans of the country and the wishes of the people. Now, in Uganda here, our education sector is run under, at least in respect to the universities, it's run under the Universities and Other Tertiary Institutions Act. This act provides for the process of accreditation of courses and how universities are set up and how they are run. I have looked at the notice that has been issued by the National Council for Higher Education, and I think it was not the most appropriate, at least to say the very least, it's not within our legal framework. The legal framework as it works is that a university gets the courses accredited, and once they're accredited, they start teaching. We do not have any provision in our law for expiry of courses. I cannot quite speak of what exactly happened with the Bristol situation. I'd be very interested to look at it and understand what happened. But what I can assure the public and I can assure everyone that if the course has been accredited before by the National Council for Higher Education, the issue of expiry does not arise. We do not have a provision in our law which talks about expiry of courses. So I want to assure the public and assure the entire country that from a legal perspective, all the courses that are being taught, once they have been accredited, they are valid, and the degrees issued therefrom are valid. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So now the National Council for Education, because it had indicated that on its website that 2,000 courses programs had expired, that means they were not authorized to be taught or they are not accredited. So now they are going to pull down that, or what should we now expect the National Council to do after your engagement with them?
First of all, I'm definitely going to engage with National Council for Higher Education, and I have actually spoken to the executive director about this to understand what the meaning of expiry in their notice meant. Because expiry in the ordinary speak means to come to an end of a period of validity. That something is valid, say if you have a driver's license, they tell you the driver's license is valid for 5 years. At the end of 5 years, that is when expiry comes. But I have looked at the law, and there is no period of validity for courses. So I think the use of the word expiry in their notice is absolutely inappropriate. And looking at the law, they should work on bringing that down and depicting the correct position that they wish to depict to the public.
Okay, as you wait for this position of the National Council for Education on the duration of the expiry, so now, as far as you are concerned, I heard from the parliament, from members of parliament, from that in that report, they were saying that once the course has been accredited by the National Council of Higher Education and the universities have the charter, so they should. There is no way. They are wondering why you have to continue re-accrediting these programs. Should they be re-accredited, or should it be once and then we move on?
There is really no provision for re-accreditation of courses. But like anything in society, we change. And with time, for example, we have had new laws that have been enacted since I left university. We have had different decisions that have been made since I left university. It doesn't mean that you re-accredit the course. You may enhance the course, you may make it better, you may include new things, but it doesn't mean that you re-accredit the course. So there is no provision again in the law for reaccreditation of courses.
So the word we should be using is review.
If anything, it would be review, under review, that we are reviewing it, we are enhancing, we are making it better. But it is not, once you have recognized, because accreditation is recognizing, someone as a particular status, acknowledging that, for example, Makerere University can teach law. That is the accreditation. So you accredit the course and say, this is the course for Makerere University law. You can go on and review and add new authorities and etc., but doesn't mean that after some time, you stop recognizing Makerere University as teaching law. Absolutely, the use of the word expiry is absolutely wrong. The use of the word reaccreditation is absolutely wrong. At least it has no place in the law.
Okay. Now, if you are now speaking to the affected students, those ones who had applied for further studies in UK and other countries, who have been notified that they were not be eligible for admission to graduate studies, what would you tell them now? Because it's now, yeah, we can say yes, it is okay, but outside, we may not graduates here may not be welcome for further studies or even jobs in Europe and North America.
I think what I can advise all students, one is that when you get a communication of that nature, I encourage you to go back to the university that issued that qualification and have them communicate with the university and explain to them what happened. In the meantime, as government, we are going to work around the clock to ensure that National Council of Higher Education brings down that notice and makes a clear explanation to the public and the world that in our law there is no provision for accreditation, reaccreditation.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Attorney General. I hope we are going to get back to you. Just stay tuned and be with us.
Sure.
Thank you very much. Let me get back to the studio and talk to Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, who had acknowledged that some programs they are running under review, and blamed the National Council, said it blamed all this on the laxity on the part of the National Council, on the part of the university, that is Makerere University, and the National Council for the delay in reviewing. So you have heard from the Attorney General. He says the law is under our law, there is no provision for expired courses. So what do you make of that?
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Attorney General for clarifying the position regarding this issue as per the law. And this is not a new thing, by the way. That social clip about Bristol denying a student admission came up last year. And I indeed got concerned, and we contacted the executive director and said, is it true? I had not checked what was on the website. But of course, my colleagues then checked and said, yeah. It is some courses are being described as expired. And we did get concerned, and we approached the National Council and advised that that was not correct. But we had not even checked that the clip was correct. So we agreed with the National Council that they needed to update their website and put correct description that courses were under review and not expired. And the executive director promised they were going to do that, but of course said they are understaffed and that kind of thing. So we thought that was done and they were going to handle it. The clip, which was picked up by one of the local papers, was a recycling of what had appeared last year. I was in a meeting with the Vice Chancellor of the University of Bristol, because we are members of a group which is called Worldwide Universities Network, from which I just returned last night. And I asked her, Is it true you are subjecting Makerere to this kind of thing? Because we are, they recognize us as equals. And all universities worldwide, they check whether the university is accredited by their national accreditation. They don't go into details of which programs and so on. And thousands of Makerere students and students from other universities in Uganda are attending these universities, including all the other top universities that we know about, Harvard, Cambridge, and so on. We have our students there, and nobody has ever asked about Makerere's accreditation. So that came as a surprise, and when I asked her, she actually got surprised and said, well, I'm going to check with my admission office, but that should never happen. So we are waiting for them to confirm whether this is true or whether it is just people playing around with the internet. So the review of programs is a normal thing, and we have been doing it in Makerere even before the National Council came up, as the Attorney General has explained, because things change, the world is changing, technology changes, and so without the National Council, we review our programs. And the review doesn't mean that the program has expired. So I am really very grateful that the Attorney General has clarified this issue. The information I have, although I was traveling, is that the National Council has pulled down that thing, and all the programs are now indicated as accredited. Mm-hmm. But it is unfortunate that they waited for all this
to happen.
Because if Makerere was not a strong brand, we would be in problems. But I think most other universities, they are not bothered about what was there.
Mm-hmm.
But we should indeed be very careful with the things we put on our websites.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Professor Mpesa Mingo.
Yeah.
Were you one of the universities affected?
Yeah, for sure. Of course, you know, this is the first time we are receiving a beating altogether.
Mm-hmm.
public and private. Actually, it's a big national problem, and it's very unfortunate. What I would like our viewers to appreciate, first of all, is how universities design, prepare, and also deliver curricula. You know, because the curriculum, KIU, for example, would have a program in Bachelor of Pharmacy. I want to produce pharmacists. So I put together my professors, my senior lecturers, and then they come up with what they call a Bachelor's of Pharmacy. And that is content, logical flow, you know, the kinds of people I need, the staffing levels, the reference materials, and then I do a stakeholder analysis, I get feedback, I go to industry. Then that actually defines my Bachelor of Pharmacy as my institutional program. So curricula belong to the universities. That's why institutions are given what we call academic autonomy. Now after that, as Professor Nawang has rightly said, previously we had self-regulation. I and him and a few other people belong to a generation where we trained, I'm an alumnus of Makerere, we trained and graduated prior to the establishment of the National Council for Higher Education. But because of the massification, government saw it wise that there are too many universities that are coming. Before, there used to be only Makerere. 10 years from 1988 when IUIU came on board, then in the 90s, 2001, the act which the Honorable Attorney General is talking about was put in place. 2003, the National Council came into existence. And because of the, you know, so many universities coming up, it was wise to have regulation. So if I design my curriculum, and it needs to be monitored so that we do not cheat the public, so that we do not deliver poor quality standards. And so the National Council for Higher Education was established to set up minimum standards. You know, something that is minimum, in this case of accreditation, and the Attorney General is absolutely right, it's accreditation. The question is that curriculum accredited? So once it is accredited, it runs, and there are different periods. Some run for 3 years, others run for 5 years, others even run for more years.
In Tanzania, they run for 5 years.
Exactly. So, but some degrees run for 3 years, others 5.5, 6 years, depends. And even internationally, and Professor Nawange is even witness to that, some programs can stretch up to 7 years. So now, as a university, the owner of the curriculum, mm-hmm. I should recognize that over a certain period, once my first batch of graduates have gone out, mm-hmm. I should pique interest in their experiences at work, look at any gaps, then come back and consider if I need to do some additions, or I want to remove other content, or introduce technology now that it's the thing that is selling, and then I should be able to improve this curriculum through my structures and notify the National Council. But remember, I already have accreditation, so this is so important. Now, the error that was done, and as you have heard, it's a wrong thing for the information to have gone on the website, and then, you know, programs that were previously accredited to be highlighted as expiry. In fact, there is also active. You know, active, I don't think is also in the law. So I think we should maintain what is in the law, accreditation. What I object completely is for an institution to launch a program that is not accredited at all. That one is not even expired, it is beyond expired, it is illegal. Mm. And even those awards cannot be recognized. So that's our take, we are in it all. It has affected all of us, and I think we need to do more sensitization and reassure our current students, previous students, and the prospective ones. The danger, Mr. Kashaka, is that this is the first time we are receiving students who have not the A-level leavers for the first time. Remember, we were in a lockdown, and so this confusion really should be cleared, clarified, and of course the ministry has come out, the National Council has also issued a statement that no, if you have ever received accreditation, your program is accredited, is recognized, and the award is also recognized. But how do we undo the damage caused to the higher education sector in the country? And Professor Nawango is saying probably this was like a fake story, but fake story that is having, you know, a tough hit on us in the universities.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Professor Nawangwe, when did this the use of expired word, I mean, come into existence? National Council for Education, has it been using this word expired? Or it is the first time they are posting this?
As I told you, we were all not aware that there was that kind of description of our programs on their website until what I believe now is a fake story, because I've met the Vice Chancellor, and she says they could never do such a thing. But in a way, maybe it is good that it happened, because it is now clarifying a lot of things. I do believe that after accreditation, universities should be left to review their programs. If the National Council is interested to track that these programs are being reviewed, they should just be asking, have you reviewed your programs? And maybe giving some kind of reminder and so on. But as I have said, this came up last year after that story in the social media. And that's when we got concerned and realized, oh, they are using the word expired. And we expressed our concern. And we were told it was going to be, the website was going to be updated. That is more than 6 months ago. If they had done that at the right time, this wouldn't have happened. But maybe it is okay it happened, because we are definitely going to discuss on how we move forward in our relationship with the National Council.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So as far as we are concerned, how should you move forward with the National Council?
We have got a meeting of the Vice Chancellor on Monday, where we have invited the Executive Director to have a discussion. The Executive Director has also invited universities from the communication. I think after that meeting, somehow it was, at that time, for us, we were inviting her, she was also inviting us, maybe before she saw our letter. Mm. But we expect her to come to Makerere University, where the vice chancellors are coming, to address this issue. And we shall discuss on how we move along with these issues so that we do not get a repeat of this very unfortunate incident.
Mm-hmm. Professor Mpeza Mwinga, are you looking forward to that meeting with the National Council for Education?
Yes, I think what the website information brings out, definitely there were mistakes. The lists that were pasted, at least I did a search with my team, what had been put against Kampala International University, you'd find there was need for an update. You know, some programs we never offer, some had been reintegrated, others, actually even the most recently accredited ones, some of them were missing. So we understand, and I even spoke to the ED of the National Council, and I said, I think...
That is Mary.
Professor Mary Okwakol, who is our dear friend. She's a former vice-chancellor. She knows it all. And I was saying, I think there is a problem with the team that is supposed to be doing the communications. Because even as late as yesterday morning, you know, the communications team had not yet even uploaded the clarification which National Council had given. So there could be some issues internally. So for me, I think we need to address the issue. And by the way, we need to also link it to what is happening in higher education in Uganda. Mm. The primary curriculum has been, you know, secondary, lower secondary has been worked on. Mm. The National Curriculum Development Center is busy trying also to finalize the, you know, the A-level curriculum. Us in universities, I think this is now an opportunity for us to actually do a consideration of the review of our curricula. Okay, what happened was not a good thing, but we need to pick out the opportunity from it. So what is the opportunity? The opportunity is that as a university, as Kampala International University, we have set up our teams. We are now looking at our programs, the way they are. They are set, they are designed. And then we harmonize with the National Council so that this issue of, you know, appearing on the website with information that is not really up to date is also sorted out. And then we engage them. We also ask ourselves internal questions now of considering, you know, coming up of new programs and trying to make sure that the graduates we are churning out are really fitting in the marketplace. One area that we need to improve as universities, and most universities don't do it, is to conduct tracer studies. Those tracer studies involve going for your alumni and trying to interact with them, trying to probe the curricula that they went through, their work experiences, and then informing the curriculum. You know, it has to be two-way. So universities have got to look for funds and resources and invest. And in fact, the National Council has an opportunity also to support institutions, convince government to provide more money, so that now universities address a bigger issue, not the expiry of curricula, mm-hmm. but the enhancement of curricula, and also matching it with the job market. Because there are usually so many complaints. They say we are graduating, you know, people who are unemployable. But the people also forget that the job market also is saturated. Now, how do we do it? Do we close the universities? Do we reduce the number of programs? Do we orient the curricula to be more competence-based, skills-based, vocational-based? Don't we also have an opportunity to think about the job offers outside our borders? Because the Ugandan education system has always been considered to be very, very good and very competitive. So my take on this is that this has come. Let's discuss it as a country. Let's find an avenue of clearing the air at the global stage, internationally. There are different fora. And then in-house, the institutions also work to see how we now reintegrate things, how we now update our information, and also submit reports to the National Council so that they have up-to-date information. Whereas now it seems to be the turn of National Council, also institutions have their own issues, you know, delays in submission. National Council also has delays in responding. So there's that lag that we need to address and find a mechanism where we can have one-on-one with the National Council. Call KIU. I send you my technical team. They sit with your technical team at the National Council, try to clean up, and then we have harmonized website linkages.
Thank you very much. Professor Nawango, is the National Council for Education sleeping on the job? They have been media shy since the story broke. We have been trying to reach them, but they have not been responding positively, apart from issuing statements. But they, when you were engaging Professor Mary, who is the former vice chancellor, was she remorseful? Was she aware that on their website they had the word expired?
First of all, let me make a comment on what my colleague has talked about. Yes. This issue of the public and even some employers saying, you know, our products are not employable. And first of all, I have argued and I continue to argue that there are no jobs which you are talking about. If the jobs were there, you would even take the bad products. But the jobs are not there. Mm-hmm. Now, what universities are tasked to in the modern age, and especially those of us who are in the developing world, it is these products that are going to create the jobs. We cannot pretend that we have jobs, but we do not have people to employ. Otherwise, you would even go and recruit them from outside. Mm-hmm. But the jobs are not there. Mm-hmm. So the biggest task we have as universities is now to produce graduates who are going to create employment for the multitude of other young people who are coming out who do not even have that privilege of coming to university. Mm-hmm. That's what we should be focusing on, instead of arguing that we are producing products that cannot be employed.
Mm-hmm. The quality, people are questioning the quality of
graduates. That's not true. How come that they leave from here? By the way, our students go and they become the best graduate students in foreign universities. Mm-hmm. If the quality was poor, would they be doing that? They even recruit them to retain them because they are the best people they have. So let's not be deceiving the public that, you know, quality is bad. And
so it's the jobs that are not available.
The jobs are not there. And we have to create those jobs.
Yes, yes.
Now, but in some situations, Professor, as you know, the jobs are there, but the capacity to hire is not there. I'll give you an example. You know how many medical doctors you have. You know you have. We produce doctors. Many universities. The health centers.
Sorry to cut you short, Professor Mpezamingo. Honorable KK.
Yes.
Yeah. You heard from the professors we have here.
Yes.
National Council for Education. They say had not even. They were dragging their feet as well as pulling down that positive consent. Do you think some officials there are sleeping on their job? What is happening there?
Well, I can't really say that people are sleeping on the job. I think what we need to work on, and I'm pleased that the professors have advised that, have reported that they'll be having a meeting with the National Council for Education on this issue. I think we need all, and I do not. We need to assure the public that once the course is accredited, it is valid and remains valid. Now, we should work quickly, and like they said, when they have their meeting, they should work quickly and remove any doubt or any conflicting communication to the public. But definitely, I'm going to get back and also speak to National Council for Higher Education, because it's important that we act on these things quickly, so we don't continue to have this damaging information, which is not necessarily correct, sent out there.
When I was doing some research about this, I discovered that in Tanzania, academic programs expire after five years, and universities have to submit and then have them re-accredited before they admit students. So maybe they also picked leave from there to use that word expired.
I've not quite addressed my mind to the position in Tanzania. You see, like I said when I was in the beginning, laws are made to deal with the circumstances of a society. Mm-hmm. What Uganda has, and the professors there have explained to you where this came from. There was there was the training in higher education long before 2003. I graduated from Makerere University in 1996, 97. Now, at this point, National Council of Higher Education didn't exist. So it evolved. When society evolved and we had many more universities coming in, the need to supervise them. But remember, we have a history where universities were self-regulating. So to say that Makerere University, which has been around for 100 years, all of a sudden was able to self-regulate itself all these years, and all of a sudden now their degrees expire in 5 years, is a question that we need to look at as Parliament and then make a decision whether that is how far we have dropped, which I don't think we have. Mm. So universities have a certain degree of self-regulation, and they are just simply monitored by National Council of Higher Education. The moment the first stage of accreditation is done, the rest is continuous monitoring. Are you doing well? Are people teaching? And etc. That doesn't mean that the course has expired. So it definitely the position in Tanzania, I have not read on it, and I will definitely interest myself in it, is not the position of the law in Uganda. Mm-hmm. And therefore it cannot be used as the position here. Even if it is a good practice, we need to, as stakeholders, have a conversation about it and then agree through amendment of the laws to say, okay, now we have realized that this is a good practice, let us make it part of our legal regime. But it cannot be made part of a legal regime simply because it's a good practice somewhere else. Mm.
Thank you very much. Since this story was broken, National Council, it's now coming to the week. National Council for Higher Education still has on its website courses, the indicator as active and expired. They seem to have a point, and to the public out there, when they say, you came out on Wednesday, you spoke on the floor of Parliament, the professors here have told me they have been engaging the Professor Mary, the Executive Director of National Council for Education, who is a former Vice Chancellor. And the situation on the website that status quo still remains. They seem not to be bothered about what is happening. Ugandans may not take you seriously, Attorney General.
No, Ugandans have to take me seriously on matters of law, because the National Council of Higher Education is not mandated to advise the country on matters of law. I have advised the country that description of expired is not provided for in our legal regime. Now, unless National Council of Higher Education comes out and shows us a provision of the law under which they describe a provision as expired, it's absolutely unacceptable, and we are going to engage them. I will engage with the Minister for Higher Education, who has also issued a statement on this issue, and clarify that what they meant as expired should have been under review, and that's it. So the public needs to really take me very, very seriously on this issue, and I call upon the country to remain calm. We are going to deal with this issue and have it resolved at the earliest, and we are going to ensure that the correct communication on the position is sent out to the public.
As we wait for you to do this, I pray that the National Students Association had threatened to drag universities to court over this issue. And if you National Council for Education continue to drag its feet, take long to pull down this post, don't you think that you risk being sued?
No, you can't sue the university for doing the right thing.
For running academic programs that the regulator says are not authorized to be taught.
It is not what the regulator says, it is what the law says and what the facts are. If indeed a university is teaching a program which is not accredited by National Council for Higher Education, that is absolutely illegal. No university should have a course which has not been accredited by National Council for Higher Education. But once the program is accredited, then you cannot say that it expired. So the problem is not the university, the problem is the communication. So what the students need to be working on is to take National Council to court, maybe to remove the notice, which I don't think will be necessary, because we have clarified this and it is going to be resolved. So what we can request is that the students just remain calm, and we are going to come to the bottom of this as quickly as humanly possible.
As a seasoned lawyer, we have heard from Professor Barnabas Nawango saying universities should be allowed to review, to do the review themselves of these programs or courses. Do you think, and then the National Council for Education, for Higher Education, just comes in to make sure that, to ascertain whether this has been done. Should the National Council be the one doing this, or universities should see high time that the universities did this?
I think, first of all, that is not a matter of law really at this point, but for me, it is a shared responsibility. National Council for Higher Education cannot review a course which the university has not presented to them. So it is a shared responsibility. So the university will come up and say, this is how I want to go about this, and National Council may come in to advise on how it can be made better, how it can be made more efficient, and more useful to society. It's a shared responsibility. I would not want us to say it is done by National Council and then leaving out the university, because it's not possible, or even leaving out National Council. So both of them need to work together to make sure that we achieve the desired results.
Thank you very much. You are a government official. You are Attorney General, but at the same time, you also you have your businesses. You have your chamber, the KK, the Company Advocates. You are an employer. Employers have been saying that the graduates, that the students, universities keep churning out if they are, their quality is not good. As an employer or as a chief government legal officer, what do you say about the quality of graduates?
I don't think it is correct and appropriate to lump up everyone and say the graduates are bad. So an employer may chance upon a student who was not good. Even at the time we were in school, there were some students who were better than others. There were some students in our class who were better than us. And so it cannot be said that all of us were bad, all of us were good. Obviously, we must appreciate the circumstances that we are operating with. Society has grown. The population has grown. There are so many changes in society that have happened. 20 years ago, not many people were in ICT. Now many are in ICT. The question is, have we adapted? Have we changed our system? I don't think it's correct to say that everyone is bad. We have some institutions which are doing well, others are not doing well. But these are the circumstances that the university administration need to look at and continuously address. Because the circumstances keep changing, the conditions of society keep changing, and we need to adapt to those. But just by the way, just for clarification, I am on sabbatical now from K&K Advocates. I am full-time employed by a government, and I do not want you to leave that record to say that I am still unemployed. I'm on sabbatical, and when I finish my tour of duty, the pleasure of the appointing authority, then maybe I could go back to K&K.
Thank you very much for that clarification, KK.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we are going to take, I don't know whether you have the last word on this issue of accreditation and so on.
Yes,
before we go, we take a break.
Last word, Omar, is to all the listeners and countrymen and countrymen in Uganda. Once a course has been accredited by National Council for Education, it is valid and remains valid. I am assuring the public that no degree or course has expired which has been accredited by National Council of Education in accordance with the laws of Uganda. So I request that you remain calm, and as the professors have advised, they are going to sit and meet and work on how best they can communicate the positions in the university better. But let's remain calm, and anyone who has an issue of this nature, I'm calling upon them to get in touch with their universities, and their universities can be able to go out and clarify on these issues.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everyone, for listening to me. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Professor, we are going to take a quick break, but before we do that, we want to conclude this issue of expired inverted commas, expired academic programs, but still on the website of this National Council for Education. It is not even put in quotes. It's just open that expired, active, and the program. So they seem to be, for them, they seem to know what they are doing. But and the foreign institutions, when they are, I think, going to admit, they check the websites. They move with what is on the website of this, no. The official accounts of the website of these institutions.
Mr. Kashaka, as I have mentioned before, the institutions out there really don't check those things. That the institution checks whether the university is accredited.
The university?
Yes, by the National Council. And as I've told you, there are thousands of Ugandans from Ugandan universities who are studying out there, even on programs that are assumed to have expired.
So they don't check programs whether...
It is not the issue. Because once the university has given a degree and it is accredited, the other university recognizes that degree. Now, but we have to be, I think, fair. I think it is a bit of a slow movement of information. The information I have is that the National Council, first of all, they issued a statement where they say accredited programs remain accredited. That is the most important thing. I think they have pulled out of...
it's still there. I will check it.
They have clarified that. Yes. They have issued a circular.
What okay. I'm saying, on their website, and they still going, have a table
they
are going there.
They have started correcting them.
Yes.
Because I've seen a lot which had been as expired, they have now been put as accredited.
Mm-hmm.
Already, they are beginning. They are working on it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think they can do it over... As you know, there are thousands of all these programs.
Mm-hmm.
We have more than 50 universities.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're dealing university by university. And so they are going to correct that, I have no doubt, because they have already issued a circular anyway,
mm-hmm.
saying all the programs, once accredited, they remain accredited. But we review in order to check that you are still doing the right thing and so on. They have explained that.
Mm-hmm.
Still on this issue of... quality of graduates. I mean, ironically, at this meeting I was, my colleagues from the UK were saying it is the same thing people in the UK say, that they are teaching people who are not employable. But who is employing? I mean, so it is a worldwide thing. People always say, no, these people are not, because employers expect that when somebody comes to be employed, they already know what to do. They don't realize that these people are coming from university. They may have the basics, but you need to train them on the job, okay? And even they who are saying that went through the same.
Thank you. Thank you, yes. Professor. Yes. I'm told the Honorable Medard Segona is on phone. Good morning, Honorable.
Good morning to you, my brother.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
This is the press wall, the show that makes sense of the major events of the week.
I'm very happy to participate.
Every Saturday morning.
My pleasure being with you.
We have had the Attorney General there saying there is all courses are still valid. That maybe it was the bad use of the choice of the word was not by the National Council to say expired was not the right thing to do the right word to use. You are aware of this. I'm sure you are aware. You have been following the events as they pan out. What do you make, first of all, of the reports that some foreign institutions had notified applicants that the courses they did were listed as expired?
Have since expired.
Yes.
You know,
and they are still expired. The word expired is still used on the website of National Council for Education, for higher education.
Well, first, I'm happy to join the professors. I'm not half a professor myself, although I have taught law at the university. Secondly, I am also speaking as an alumni of one of those universities mentioned. Sadly, I am speaking as a parent paying fees for students at the university, but I also speak as a leader in this country and particularly supervising some of the institutions in issue. At the accountability level, I and my group supervise Makerere University and other public universities and tertiary institutions. I supervise the National Council for Higher Education. I have also followed the language used to expire of degrees, not even courses, but they went to the extent of saying the degrees are expired. Actually, somebody made a joke and said, why don't we take these people to court? Then the other one said, the lawyer who is supposed to represent you also has an expired degree. Even the judge who is going to listen to you has an expired degree. One, I want to agree with the Attorney General that our degrees do not expire. If you have a degree, you have that degree till death, unless and until it is revoked by the awarding institution for just cause. Now, that university which awarded that degree has the power and liberty under the law to recall the degree if subsequently they discover, for example, that you acquired the degree fraudulently. You cheated in the exams. And we have seen some examples. I remember a professor at Makerere, one whose professorship was recalled and cancelled. I don't know about the degrees he had. Now, expiry. How would a degree expire? This is how we interpret the law. First, accreditation and reappraising those degrees is a statutory matter. It is a duty or the responsibility of the National Council for Higher Education by statute to revisit, review, accredit, and reaccredit courses. But the law does not go ahead to tell us what happens after that time stipulated if they do not do what they are supposed to do. Now, usually, once the law does not provide for a sanction, then that is supposed to be directory and not mandatory. If they had stated that failure to reaccredit or reappraise, and whatever language they use, the degrees or the courses would be cancelled, that would be the case. That's point number one. Point number two, less first facts. They are the bitter facts. Somebody somewhere slept on his job or her job. And these are two people I'm looking at. The first is Professor Nawangwe and his team at Makerere, who continued to superintend over an institution and provide courses that they knew accreditation was expiring. It is only accreditation that expires, not the degree. But those courses were there. It was their responsibility to write to the National Council and say, look, we are here providing these courses. You are supposed to come back to us and do your job. The second person, and when I talk about Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, I mean and include all other heads of institutions that have been affected or that have been mentioned and thrown into bad light. The second person who slept on duty is the person in National Council for Higher Education who we pay to sit behind a computer on a desk and knew that one of the annual outputs they are supposed to show, to give to the public, is they are supposed to go back to these institutions, look again at the courses that are provided under their stewardship and superintendence, and know that this is going to expire. Because when they come before PAC, we ask them, show us outputs, how many did you have, how many did you implement or execute? And that is how we judge and measure and gauge their performance. So they slept on duty. Now, the universities outside this country have the liberty to set the terms and conditions of their service. how they want to deal with their clients. If in their protocol they cannot admit students who undertook courses that are not accredited, and in their interpretation those courses have expired or the degrees have expired, that one is their liberty, it's a matter of their law, practice, and protocol. So I agree with the Attorney General, Honorable Chiriwa Chiwanuka. Painfully, by the way, he's not somebody I want to agree with in life, but I mean, it is the law, that degrees do not expire. Even these courses have not expired. Why? Because there are different provisions in the statute, enabling provisions in the statute that allow universities to undertake courses and to decide which courses. All they need is approval from National Council for Higher Education. And I believe they sought and obtained approval. Now, the failure to re-accredit after reappraising is another failure of another institution and a failure for a reminder, in practical sense, by these institutions that are undertaking or providing these courses. But that, the effect of that is not expiration and is not collapse of the degrees that are being provided. But of course, they should prepare. When they come before Parliament, they will explain why they have thrown us into this kind of bad PR.
So you are summoning them?
I have not said that.
What I'm saying as Parliament.
It is statutory that annually they will come before Parliament, A, to seek budget approvals, and two, to submit to supervision and oversight. I have not said I am summoning them, because I do not make individual decisions.
Okay, now this issue seems to be intricate. You are agreeing with the Attorney General that the courses are still valid. The Attorney General says they should not even be accredited, the issue of accreditation and so on. The universities, the foreign institutions are saying, no, we can't admit you. Now, if you are a student, a graduate student, and you are hearing what you are saying, and the Attorney General is saying, the university is saying, and abroad you are not welcome for further studies, what would you do?
Now, here are two relationships that you're talking about. One, as a leader and a politician, there is a political relationship between that student and the government through that awarding institution. That one requires the university and the country to pay attention to the plight of this student who is seeking further education and advancement of career. The second is a legal relationship. The legal relationship is to the effect that you used to be my student. I gave you my degree. I have not cancelled that degree. I ceased to have business with you. Now, we just need to look at both. From the legal perspective, this student can only, through the leadership of this country, to which I am not very proudly a member, to put our house in order, to ensure that Professor Nawangwe and his team, in liaison with the National Council for Higher Education, do their work. Professor Nawangwe's role is to appeal to National Council for Higher Education because he has been thrown into bad PR. National Council for Higher Education has a statutory duty. For example, I'll give you an example. As a practicing lawyer, every year I invite the law council to approve my chambers or reapprove my chambers. And it used to be to court in courts if a lawyer practiced without a practicing certificate and drafted papers. They would be thrown out and the client would suffer. Until Parliament made a law and amended the Advocates Act and said under Section 14A, the failure of an advocate to renew a license does not invalidate the documents filed in court. This is the case or the scenario where we are. that the failure to reappraise and reaccredit will not affect the degree. However, practically, a student has been denied entry until and unless these courses are revalidated, to use their language. Let us not even fight PR. Let's just rush, go back and look at these courses, reappraise in accordance with the law, and we get out of this. I don't know how long it takes. I don't know why it took them so long to realize this. I don't even know why they failed to go and do their work. So if they failed the other time to go and do their work, let them go now that they have been woken up.
So should we allow universities to do the review themselves of these courses?
No, you can't allow the university to review itself.
And then you have National Council to come in and see whether they have done the right thing.
Sir, the law is clear. It is the duty of National Council for Higher Education. National Council is an establishment of a law. It is given structures. It is funded and facilitated. You cannot ask a university to supervise itself.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Thank you very much, Honorable Meda Segona. But
thank
before
you.
I leave you and we take a quick break,
yes,
there have
sir.
Been questions about the quality of our graduates. Yes, Professor
yes.
Nawangwe has
make,
a burning issue.
Make a response to Honorable Segona.
Yes.
Yes, Honorable Segona, you are right in everything except one.
Yes,
the
sir.
Review of programs is by the universities.
Mm.
The National Council only checks that you have actually reviewed and that the review was okay. But otherwise, by law, the review is by the universities themselves.
Please do your work.
And we have been doing that, sir.
Okay, you will explain to me when we meet.
Yes.
I want to remain your student. Okay, thank you. It's been nice hearing everyone.
Honorable.
Yes, sir.
I was just asking you about the quality of graduates.
Yes, sir.
Employers, you have a chamber. You have chambers. Employers like you,
yes,
say
sir.
The students who are being churned out every year, they are not up to the standard. They are not fit to be employed.
Yes.
They don't have the required skills.
Mm.
What do you say about that? What should the universities do to be able to produce graduates who are really ready for employment with the labor force?
Well, I did tell you that I have a teaching background where I taught and I think churned out so many students in their thousands before I crossed over to this side.
Mm-hmm.
One, you see, the university receives a product that has gone through the furnace before elsewhere. That's number one. When the university is receiving a student, we will not even know whether this student cheated in exams to access the university.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, we've also been hearing some cases, most of which are unsubstantiated, that the way the university teaches and churns out students, there is favoritism, there is corruption, there is nepotism, there is sex for marks, etc. And therefore, the possibility of releasing substandard products is not remote. Number three, the role of the parent. Where is the role of the parent? You're leaving out the parent. One, you are the people who go out and buy exams. Before we talk about those corrupt public officials, talk about the parent who picks money to go and pay for an exam, to go and do coaching of some sort. ETC. The government in the past has undertaken measures. I think there was the Professor Kajubi white paper. I was a young man. I do not have much details. They were trying to review the curriculum. You've seen they are reviewing the curriculum today to bring a new curriculum, I think, in secondary schools, ETC. I mean, to conform to the emerging demands. And that one will have an effect on the quality of graduates. When I was going to university in 1997, I think by that time they had started the evening program. The challenge would be here. If you have been teaching somebody for a three-year course and award a degree, and this person has been attending education from 8 to 5, then because of the emerging demands and challenges, you introduce an existing program, and somebody wants to do the program, the same program that someone has been doing for 3 years, from 8 to 5. And this person comes in at 5:30, leaves office at 5, probably gets to the law school at 6, and then learns up to 9. I mean, it would definitely have an effect on the quality of education. Number three, the liberalization, where the money motivation is a factor. We need to relook at all those. That is not to say that the universities are not doing a good job. You see, when we were at university, they used to tell us that at university you learn the theory, you learn the principles. The university has since moved away from that and said, no, we must introduce some practical aspects. For the law students, for example, I think very soon, in June, they are sending law students to the chambers to come and do some practical training with us. I think that one is a step in the right direction intended to improve the quality. And people are doing industry training and while at university, we never used to do it. For me, university, whenever you would break off, for those of us who wanted to MOFA, you would do some MOFA-ring. I hope Professor Nawange does not send me a bill. You know, if I don't know if he knows what we mean by MUFA, Makerere University Fulukazi Association. We used to remain there in holidays and enjoy campus life, etc. Today, during those holidays, students are sent to do practical training with institutions in their areas of training. That's a good step. But we need to do a lot more, and it must be a concerted effort. For example, how do you get a churn out an engineer who stays on the street for 3 years, literally doing nothing? Makerere University should have something like a workshop where some of your best students remain and do practical things. The same things that people do in Katwe are things that your students are able to do. So it must go beyond that. And during your practical trainings, for example, when you send me a student to learn from my chambers, it is based on face value trust that I can supervise the student. There are some lawyers who do not have the kind of time I'm willing to dedicate. The university has to have an arrangement that supervises their students. In the law school, I understand there is a legal aid clinic they are establishing. That way, the lecturers themselves, who should be able to take responsibility and see whether exactly these students are learning. We send them to some lawyers. Some lawyers, of course, are broken morally. They are going to teach them the wrong things. So the universities must find a mechanism equally of supervising their students.
Thank you very much. We are going to take a breather. When we come back, I pray that you remain with us. There are some questions I wanted to pose to you about some universities like Makerere University. Their goal is to be a fully-fledged research university. Professor Mpeza Muyingo here, of the Vice Chancellor of Kampala International University, will tell us here what their goals are. So wanted to also to involve you in that conversation, Honorable. Let's take a quick break. When we come back, we shall continue with the discussion, trying to look at other issues.
I'll be very happy to.
Thank you very much, Honorable. Let's take a breather.